Hey everyone, we are Tom and Bunny, aka Towaway Couple, and I'm the driver.
And I'm the sandwich maker.
The sandwich maker. So we are doing this video in our video room. We actually have a full-on YouTube studio in our house, so we do other channels elsewhere, but we are going to be embarking on our new journey as towaway drivers for Horizon Transport.
Yes, we actually leave in 11 hours and 20 minutes.
Yes, to head to Indiana. So we said we'd do start to finish, and we did a couple videos already. We did an introductory video and then us installing the fifth wheel hitch, only because we had to get that installed right away.
Yes, and we've done what you're putting in the toolbox. And
that hasn't released yet. So.
No. Oh, that's right.
Yeah, no. And we did what's in Bunny's bag of tricks, but those will be released after this one. So, and we're going to separate them out by a few days, so that way we can make you wait for a little bit.
It's a teaser.
It's a teaser. So what got us into, well, first off, we did create a website, towawaycouple.com. Mm-hmm.
Well, you did.
Well, I did. And it's basically towawaycouple.com. We're going to put blogs, we're going to put videos, and we'll put pictures on that website because apparently we're going to have a lot of downtime.
Okay.
You can only drive for 11 hours a day, then you're screwed for eight. So they want you to sleep and everything.
So what else are we going to do?
We're going to work on websites, Twitter, Instagram, and YouTube videos. So, and along with that, definitely go like us and follow us on Towaway Couple on Twitter and Instagram.
Right, and definitely subscribe to our channel on YouTube. Please follow us.
Exactly.
Was that begging?
That is begging. Click the little bell to be notified. So, what got us into doing the towaway? And we haven't started officially yet. We have our orientation. I'm playing with my drawer. We have our orientation
on Wednesday.
On Wednesday. Mm-hmm. So, and we're going to go out there a couple days early. Right now it's Saturday. We're going to leave Sunday. We're going to be out there Sunday night. Mm-hmm. And we're going to take our truck over to Dan's Hitch and Repair Shop. I guess everybody knows about Dan's shop. So we got in there. We have a scheduled maintenance. But we will discuss what we have to do there on a different video. But that's why we're going to go up there early.
Yeah, so that way he can have it for an extra day and not, they're not rushed and we're not rushed and we're there and we're ready to roll.
Exactly. Plus, we're having a lot of stuff done.
Yes, we are.
So, all right. So,
because you go big or go home.
Go big or go home, baby. Now, go look at the Hitch video.
Yeah.
Now, we work for a travel company, and me and Bunny travel all over the nation and the world. And I do social media and I do marketing, we do videos. We also, Bunny does the sales, and she's a travel consultant. So, and we could be typically found all over the United States and are in Jamaica mostly.
Yeah.
We spend about 6 weeks a year in Jamaica.
Because we're Jamaican.
Because we're Jamaican. So anyway, we've been laid off since March 8th, and we came back from an event in Jamaica, and the whole Corona COVID hit everybody in the face like you just got punched.
Yeah. And let me tell you, we were, like we said, we were gone 15 days that time. So when we came back, you know, after being in Jamaica, not watching the news, not
knowing
anything.
Well, they don't really have news there.
No, they don't.
They got one channel, and then half the time it's nothing of importance.
Right. So we had no clue what we were coming back to.
I think they limit their population on what they know on the outside world.
Well, they want people to have fun on vacation, not worry about the news.
Didn't even think about that. I'm a news junkie.
Yeah.
So we come back. We are literally, we're employed, but they're furloughing us. Mm-hmm. So now we're going to get unemployment. We've never been on unemployment. So that was a stressful, of all of our life, the first time we go on unemployment, stressing out the government unemployment, everything under the sun. So our unemployment actually is going to run out at the end of July.
Yeah, because the pandemic insurance runs out July 31st.
Right. And so, therefore, we started panicking. Here we are, June 27th. And that's only a month. And we have bills to pay. We have car payments, just like anybody else in the world. And if we are not on unemployment, it's kind of hard to find a job when you have no money.
Exactly. Especially because we live in an itty-bitty tiny little town in Alabama. And we're too old to go to work in the plants and at right. the mills. So, I mean, if we needed to start a new job, a regular job, we would have to load up our RV and move to a big city.
Yep. And find a campground. But again, with no money coming yep. in. Now, we do have savings, but mm-hmm. kind of blew a lot of that on this venture here.
And we always taught our kids, be self-sufficient, get a job, move out of the house.
Right.
We don't want to move back to their house without a job.
So I started thinking about what can I do? We've been working in the travel industry. I was a network administrator for Blue Cross, Blue Shield, and also a network administrator for IBM. But that was 20 years ago. Yeah. So I know I'm totally out of date for those jobs. And I'm a little old for those jobs.
Yeah.
So I was getting a little panicked on my employability. If that's a word.
It is.
It is a word. Is. Okay. So I was getting a little panicked and anxiety. So I was thinking, what can I do? What can I do? Well, we have a awesome truck and we literally drove, we put 75,000 miles on it in the last 2 years, just going mm-hmm. from state to state, city to city, event to event, promoting our travel to people.
Yes. With our own RV.
With our own RV. And I thought, well, hell, my truck is equipped to pull anything. Kingpin, fifth wheel, bumper pull, you name it, I can attach it to my truck. And I'm like, we have a monthly payment, and if our unemployment runs out, I would rather the truck make its own payment.
We might as with the payment that we have on that truck, we might as well have a
house.
Right. Yeah, house.
It's an $80,000 truck.
Or definitely some type of a high-end Mercedes.
Right. But yeah, it's an $80,000 truck. The truck payment's over $900 a month. And we were just panicked because we're already more than half paid off. We only owe like $36,000 or $35,000 now. And I'm thinking, I don't want it to be repossessed.
No.
Over something so stupid as to not figuring out how to make the payment, not and then have bad credit on it and all the other crap that made me sleepless nights.
So now we're going to make the truck make its own payment.
So I thought, well, let's make the truck make its own payment. I know I'm kind of rambling because we didn't really think this through.
Because you always ramble.
I do ramble.
They'll find out soon that we ramble.
So I started researching, what can I do? What can I do? And I even looked at pulling FEMA trailers because they were going to be sending all these hundreds of trailers to California, New York, and all these places. I went out and bought a forged bumper pull hitch because you got to be able to pull 20-some thousand pounds on your hitch. Mm-hmm. And I have a class 5, and I'm like, okay. I went and ordered that. I submitted out, and they didn't pull any trailers from our area, so I never got a call, but I invested that money into that hitch, so that kind of sucked. So I thought, well, what else can I do? Can I go, like, I saw that show where they transport all the stuff for people, the shipping wars.
Yeah.
I saw that, and I'm like, I don't want to get stressful on that, but that's something I can do.
And on the road, though, but on the road, we've seen, you know, everybody hauling the RVs.
And we started seeing a lot of RVs on the road, and I'm like, wonder how to get a job doing that. And I honestly didn't know. So I was waiting for the RV manufacturers to reopen, and we were going to call them directly and say, what does it take to haul your RVs? And the more I researched, the more I started finding out they actually contract through transportation companies, such as the company we took a job with, Horizon Transport. Mm-hmm. But we also submitted applications to Indiana Transport because we were talking to an acquaintance through a mutual friend who drives for Indiana Transport.
Mm-hmm.
And I came across a video on YouTube for Synergy Transport. So I put a application in there. So of all the applications, I only put in three. And then I find out there's a bunch of transportation companies. But I only did the three applications at the time. And all three companies contacted me. But Horizon contacted me within minutes. I can't believe how fast it was. They contacted me within minutes. And I was still doing my research and everything. And then I got a contact from Synergy, which was the third application. And then I got contacted from Indiana Transport.
Correct.
Now, the ball's in my court.
Yep.
So I asked.
Pick which one.
Yep. So I started researching each company now because I didn't want to go with the wrong company. And I might be going with the wrong company. I hope not.
Right. We won't know until we get on the road.
We won't know. But I did talk to people and I asked them, that drive for Horizon. I said, what do you think of the company? After 2 years of working for them, do you still enjoy it? Are the people good? Any issues I should be aware of? And it's all been positive feedback.
Well, up until this point, with our recruiter, and we had to get a couple other people involved because of another issue, they've all been Johnny on the spot and very, very helpful.
Yeah, if I email them or if I call them, if I can't get a hold of them, I leave a message. I literally get a call back right away. And if I email them, I get an email back right away as long as they're working.
Yes.
As long as they're working. And like we emailed and the girl was off because I needed something from the doctor. And she emailed the very next day and she apologized profusely, explaining she was off for the day. So I asked Synergy at the time when I was talking to them, I said, hey, how many trailers do you have right now for people to tow? And they're like, we have 211 right now on the dispatch board. And I'm like, oh, okay. I thought that was quite a bit. So I told them I was still doing research. I was going to go visit my kids. And then I come back and I was talking to Indiana Transport and I'm like, how many do you have on your dispatch board? And he's 330. And he says, yeah, that's what they average every day, about 330. And I'm like, that's even better. And the guy I was talking to was from Indiana, well, worked for Indiana Transport. So I thought, that's awesome. And then I talked to Horizon. I said, how many do you have? And she unfortunately didn't have the ability to tell me right there because she's not a hauler. She's just a recruiter. So she goes, I don't have access to that right now. I can find it for you, but I don't have access. And I said, okay, no problem. I was just curious. Mm-hmm. So I reached out to somebody who drove for Horizon. And I said, hey, can you look on your dispatch app and see how many trailers right now there are? I'd appreciate just, I don't care what they are. I just want to know a number. And he came back with over 550 trailers that are waiting for drivers. And I thought, okay, that's another upgrade mark.
Yep.
Okay. So now they're contacting me. They're emailing me. They're answering all my questions because I've never done this before.
No. We've always done something completely different. So this is all new to us.
I'm out watching YouTube videos like you're watching us and you know, everyone tells their story, but I'm a very analytical person. I want as much information as humanly possible.
Well, and everybody seemed to have started their channel, you know, long after they've been on the road.
Right.
So they didn't have the back information as far as how to get started.
Or if they did go and get back information, they didn't forget. They just didn't include a lot of stuff because you forget things.
Oh, absolutely. You do.
So we've been watching all like hot shot videos where they have the gooseneck trailers. We've been watching the Towaway videos and everything, and they're very, very informative because they're teaching us stuff that we didn't think about. Mm-hmm. I mean, we've been pulling our own trailer, not a customer's trailer commercially, and I didn't when you're driving down the road, we didn't know that if a rock kicks up, you're responsible for that rock, even though you didn't personally throw it at the trailer. You're responsible for every little blemish on that trailer unless you do a full pre-trip inspection.
And I want to put you know, kind of relate that to if you rent a car from Hertz or right. from somewhere, you do a walk around first to verify there's no dents and scratches and point that out. Or on your home inspection, it's the same thing. You need to inspect those trailers before you pull them out. Otherwise, you're responsible.
Exactly. So now I informed both Indiana Transport and Synergy because they both called me to follow up. And I told them, I said, well, one of them, I told them, unfortunately, Horizon was Johnny on the spot. They were contacting me left and right. Didn't leave any holes in the gap. I said, so I went with the, and I researched them. They are the largest transport company out there. So that's what I wanted. I'm go big, go home. Right. But I mean, I understand smaller transport companies are probably a little more personal. So I don't know. So the quick answer was, they still need drivers. They said, you know what? Go do your hauling. Go to work at Horizon. Enjoy your time. If for some reason it doesn't work out, call us.
Yeah. That made you feel good.
That made me feel good. So in a nutshell, we are doing this because our unemployment's running out. We're excited, but we're very nervous. Mm-hmm. And I don't like the thought of sleeping in my truck 2 or 3 days. I don't like the thought of not knowing when we're going to take showers and where we're going to eat, how we're going to eat, because every dime you spend is profit.
That you're spending.
You're spending your profits.
Hence the name sandwich maker, because that's going to be my job every morning. Tom doesn't want me to have sandwich stuff spread all over while we're driving,
because I think it's a hazard.
So before we take off every morning, it's going to be my job to make sure that we have our sandwiches and our lunch and ready to roll.
Exactly.
So we'll get to eat at least one meal out, whether it's going to be breakfast or dinner. We haven't decided yet.
Right. Now, I mean, we enjoy doing our videos here in the comfort of our own home. One of the things that we're going to do is we're going to try. We have lapel microphones. We're not going to use the camera microphone, but we're going to try the microphone on the windshield of the truck and with our lapel microphones, and we're going to see how that works. Some of the videos I see where they're driving, I hear so much background wind noise, it does drive me a little bit nuts, and I'm deaf. And I can imagine if I had great hearing. So we may opt to do most of our videos when we're pulled over.
Right. So we'll either be doing them for rest areas.
Hotel rooms.
Truck stops.
Yep. Could be anywhere.
Yeah, absolutely. And one thing, though, that we have going for us is the fact that we have hauled around the whole U.S. anyways in our own RVs. So we do know a little bit of what to look for and where we can go. And we definitely know that it's virtually impossible to get a parking spot in a rest area after 10 o'clock at night.
Or after 7 at night now. And when it starts getting dark, you start losing rest area spots. And we're going to talk about all that. Mm-hmm. We are going to videotape everything from our pre-trip inspections to when we have to pull over and we re-inspect, because you should always check your hitches, make sure no one pulled your fifth wheel while you're sleeping and you didn't realize it, because that has happened to people. Checking your tire pressures.
Making sure you have your tires
and torquing. Everything under the sun, we are going to be doing different videos on. And we definitely invite you to subscribe to our channel. Follow us on Twitter, Instagram, because we're going to be posting pictures and different little tiny videos along the way.
And also, too, on product that we're trying, because I'm a girly girl, so I am not going to be able to just throw my hair up in a hat.
No.
You know, go without makeup. So different things. I've already got some things waiting for me at the hotel. So definitely
in Indiana,
because I couldn't get them in my small town in time. So definitely keep an eye on our channel and definitely subscribe and follow us.
Yeah. And everything that we talk about, we will put a description down in our description of the video. And if we can, we'll put Amazon link, because that's the cheapest way of getting it. Mm-hmm. And we invite you to check it out. Like, I just got these toolboxes and I didn't do a video on it, but I'll do a video on the install.
Yeah. Those are pretty cool. I didn't even know they existed.
And here I was stressing on it because it didn't come with any install papers. They had one little image on their promotion on Amazon, and it said step 1, 2, and 3, and that was it. And literally, I had it installed in 5 minutes. It was so easy. So we're going to do an install video on the driver's side when we get to Indiana.
Yes, absolutely.
So, all right. We just wanted to add to our introduction.
Yes. Now that we're comfy and clean and sweating.
Yep. If you have any questions, if you have any comments, if you have any suggestions, if you are a Towaway driver and you can add to our channel, we would love for you to comment on our videos because we don't know everything.
We don't know nothing right now.
We don't know shit. But we also, we learn from other people.
We do. And we absolutely do.
And we hope whatever we put out here helps you.
Right. And that's the whole reason why we do them. So we can help somebody else get started too. We hate to learn by mistakes. Unfortunately, it happens. But you know what? If we've made a mistake and we can put out there so somebody else doesn't make it, then it helps.
And wait till you see the videos, because we haven't done them yet, where we talk about my DOT physical.
Oh, God.
The DOT drug test. Oh, that was so stressful. And no, I don't take drugs, but we'll explain all that. What else do we go through? Oh, my registration.
That's the worst.
And by these videos, we hope they help you.
Yes, definitely. Definitely.
So, all right, until next time. And these videos will be very randomly put up.
Yeah, because we can only do them when we get time.
Yep, so definitely subscribe. You see it at the bottom right underneath Bunny. And click the little gray bell to be notified of our videos. Please comment.
Yes.
Please comment. And if you could help us, we would appreciate it.
Yes, so definitely. Please subscribe and... I guess it's about time to get going.
Yep. All right. So we got to go to bed. We got to be off on our way to Indiana, and we will be doing a video along the way.
Correct. So we'll see you down the road.
All right. Bye-bye.